Okay, here's the lesson that we did today. Systems of equations number 5. We did this on a Desmos activity. So we've got a situation. Senior class from Cappuccino and San Mateo plan a trip to Los Angeles. All the vans were the same size and all the buses were the same size. How many students fit in the van? How many students fit in the bus? So we've got the CAP condition where CAP rented 3 vans and 6 buses with 396 students. Okay, so in this situation, if I had 0 students in a van, I have 3 times 0, and I have 6 buses, so the question is how many students would we need to put in each bus if we had 396 students to put onto a bus, and none of them were in the vans. And so if I do 396 divided by 6, we end up with 66. Okay. And the other thing is, what if I had 0 students fitting on the bus? Well, we know we've got 3 vans. We're going to put nobody on the bus, and the total number of students we need to put onto the bus is 396. So if we do 396 divided by 3, we figure out that we're going to have 132 students. Now, clearly, it makes no sense that we would have 132 students in a single van, and it doesn't make sense that we'd have 66 students on the bus. But anyways, the idea was to get an equation, the general equation. So if there are 3 vans, the number of students on the van is going to be 3x. If we got 6 buses, the number of students combined on the buses is going to be 6y, and the equation is going to be 396. Okay, and we did this the other day with the caps and the hats activity. So same situation, San Mateo rented 4 vans and 12 buses, and they had this many students. So I'm going to write the equation first. So 4 vans, so we're going to have 4x plus, and we've got 12 buses, so we got 12y, and together that adds up to 768. Okay. So how many students would be on the bus? So okay, you might want to hit pause for a second to think about this. Okay, so if I have 0 students on the bus, that means all of these 768 kids have to go onto the bus. So I do 768 divided by 12, and I'm going to get 64. Okay. Now, if no kids went on the bus, then all 768 kids would have to go be dispersed onto the 7 vans, which would be 192. If you do 768 divided by 4, we get 192. Okay. So the question is, when we solve for x and solve for y, given these two equations, we're going to get our ordered pair. Now, you did this on Desmos in class, so I'm going to plot these points right here. So let's just do this in red, okay? So I've got 0, 66. 0, 66 is right there. And 0, 32. Oh, sorry, 132, 0, 1, 2. So 132, 0, and this one over here was 0, 66. And then I draw a line connecting those values. Now our scale might not be perfect because I'm kind of doing this by eye with, you know, here it's like 50, 60. It's hard to get exact, but we're going to get pretty close. Desmos will get it exact for you. Okay, now I need to plot these points here. I got 0, 64, and 192, comma 0. So I'm going to plot those points. 0, 64 is going to be down here. And 192 is going to be over here. So I'm going to connect. Okay. Pretty darn close. So this one here was 0.64, and this here was 192, comma 0. And this intersection that you found on Desmos, when you typed in the equation in Desmos, you got 12, comma 60. Okay. So your ordered pair, you should write 12, comma 60. And the most important thing, which most of you haven't done, and I kept bugging you, you need to write your solution out in words. So what does 12, comma 60 mean? So this means on the bus, each van holds 12 students. And each bus holds 60 students. Okay, that's what this intersection means. Okay, so this is what you should have gotten from doing the Desmos activity. So make sure you have this carefully in your notes. This will help you when you're preparing for your test. Okay, now we did this part here to kind of get us started, okay? This is not part of the thing, but okay, you know a dime is worth $0.1. You know a quarter is worth $0.25. So in this example, if you have 24 dimes and 38 quarters, how much money do you have? Okay, so I've got 24 and 38. How much money do I have? Well, we know a dime is worth 10 cents, or is worth 0.1 of a dollar. We know a quarter is worth 0.25. And so now I can do this calculation. This is going to give me 2.4. And 38 times 25, let's see what that is. And I get 9.5. And so we add 9.5 and 2.4, and we get 11.9. Okay, so we're going to have to do that for our equation over here. So I'm going, since you spend a lot of time in class going over this, I'm going to just talk about the general equation. There are 68 coins. Some of them are dimes, some of them are quarters. Okay, so we're always going to have 68 coins. The question is, if I have 0 dimes, then that means I've got 68 quarters. If I've got 0 quarters, that means I have 68 dimes. So regardless, I'm either going to have 68 total coins, and they're either going to be dimes and quarters. So we figured out that this equation here has to be x plus y equals 68. Okay, so here we'd have something like 0 plus 68 equals 68 plus 0. Okay. All right. This equation is the most important thing. Okay. Now, the total amount of my dimes and quarters added up costs $9.20. So this was the harder part to figure out. So the equation was the important thing. So I know that x is the number of dimes I've got, and it's going to be times 0.1. And the quarters, it's going to be 0.25 times y. And that adds up to $9.20, 9.2. Okay. So be careful what you've written here. There were some people that were forgetting to write the y. They forgot to write the equal sign. They were being a little careless with what they were writing here. So, so let's see what we. Okay, these points are what we're going to use to plot our data. So if I've got two dimes, that means that's going to give us 20 cents, 0.2, right? So two dimes gives me 20 cents. So the rest of the $9, because this is all supposed to be added to 9.20, if I've got $9, how many quarters do I have? So if I do 9 divided by 0.25, that tells me I'm going to have 36 quarters. Okay, so what did we do? We had 36 times 0.25, because a quarter is worth 25 cents. And if I multiply 36 times 0.25, that's going to give me $9. And then if I add the 20 cents together, that adds up to 9.20. If you're a little confused on this, we watch this little part just again, until you may need to listen to it a couple times. So this is my 20 cents, this is my $9, it adds up to $9.20. Okay, the next part is a little easier. What happens if I have no quarters? So I have $9.20 all in dimes. So that means I'm going to have 92 dimes. How did I get that number? If I have 92, and we know a dime is worth 0.1 of a dollar, 10 cents, right? If I have 92 dimes, multiply it by 0.1, we're going to end up with 9.2. So 92 dimes is going to give me $9.20. Might want to think about that for a second and hit pause. Okay, so now I'm going to plot these points, 0, 68, and 68, 0 on my graph. So 68 goes right there, and 68 goes right there. So I'm going to draw that line. Okay. Similar to what you saw in your Desmos activity. And then now I'm going to plot 236. Right there. And 92, 0. Okay. 236. 92, 0. Okay, Okay, and I draw those lines and connect it. And when you did this on Desmos, you found out the intersection was 52, 16. So what does this mean? This means when I have 68 coins total, and when I've got $9.20, then that means I'm going to have 52 dimes and 16 quarters. Okay, so let's write this here. I have 52 dimes and 16 quarters. Okay, so this is what we did when we practiced our Desmos, and I hope this